Welcome to Nari Bukharazi and I'm Meenu. So in today's video, I'll be talking about top 5 books that made me cry so very much. So I'm someone who loves to read a lot of emotional books. I love the emotional factors add up into the book. So that's what makes the book so very real. Yeah, so I'll be telling about these 5 books. So I'll not be going into detail about this book. So I'll be just telling what this book is all about. So if you want a deep and descriptive video about each and every book that I'm going to talk, so please let me know about it on the comment box below so that I'll make a video on these books as well. So let's get into the show so that we can get to know about my top favorite books that made me cry so very much. So the first book on the list would be Cecilia Ahern's P.S. I Love You. So this is one of a very famous book. I hope everyone would have come across this movie or this book at least once in their lifetime. So it's such a wonderful book. So this is the first book that made me cry so very much. So I read this book some 5 to 6 years back, and even before that I was eyeing this book for so many years, and I could still remember the time I was reading this book because I was so very emotional. I was choked up, I was whimpering and crying like anything. So this is the first book that made me cry so much. So that's why it's very close to my heart. So this is a story of two people, childhood sweethearts who get to marry each other. They have a very happy life and life goes very smoothly, and suddenly the husband dies because of a deadly disease. So how this woman, she deals with her husband's death and how she moves forward in her life. So that is the story of this book. But the interesting thing is how her husband actually helped her in getting her life back together even after his death. So that is the most interesting thing about this book. So it's a very emotional read, and I would suggest everybody to read this book. Even if you have watched this movie, I think you might think like, oh, I don't want to read this book, I've already watched the movie. But I would say, no, the book is so much more better than the movie. Please read this book. So the next book on the list would be Meet Me in Bombay by Jenny Ashcroft. So this book got released last year, and it's one of my top most favorite and the best book that I've ever read so far. And I would like to give you some additional information as well. So among these 5 books that we are discussing today, this is the book that made me cry the most, like literally the most, because I was crying for around 70 to 80% of this book, and I literally lost sense of my tears and whether I was crying or not, because you know the tears were automatically flowing and I was still reading the book. And I'll tell you the gist of this book. So this is a story of two people in British India, so particularly in Bombay. So how they fall in love, how their life are affected due to the World War I that is happening behind them. So that is the story of this book. So I generally like books that are, you know, written on the backdrop of war, and this book is the best that I have written in such a kind of scenario. So if you are someone who thinks that, you know, you cannot handle these kind of sad stories and emotional books, and if you think, okay, I cannot be reading this book, it's not good for me, then I would highly suggest you to please read this book, because it's totally worth all the pain and crying. So it is one of the best books I have read, and I want everybody to read this book. So the next book on the list would be Karna's Wife by Kavita Khanna. So I'm someone who is really very fond of mythology, and I picked up this book in the first place because I'm a great fan of Karna. I love him so very much and I wanted to know more about him. So that is why I picked up this book. So it was not very emotional, like it was not so much, you know, cry worthy and all, but the thing is it made me cry so very much after the death of Karna. And what I would like to talk about precisely is the conversation that Duryodhana has with Karna's wife after Karna's death. So it was mind-blowingly insane. I cried so much in that part. So that chapter was the one that made me cry literally very much. So I was buddy reading this book with my father and I was reading it aloud. So what I did was I couldn't handle it it anymore. So I literally stopped, I closed the book, I cried for at least for 10 to 15 minutes, and I literally cursed everybody who treated Karna badly and lowly. So I cursed them, I was so very angry with everybody, and in the end I only liked Duryodhana because he was the only one who helped Karna and, you know, gave him the status that he deserved. So this is my favorite book and I love it so much, and I would also recommend you to read this book. So after reading this book, I was also interested to read about another character, that is Duryodhana. So this book is written by Anand Neelakandan, Rise of Kali. So it is the second book in the Ajaya series. So it is Mahabharata written from Duryodhana's perspective. So this book is the second book in the series, and this is the book that made me cry so very much. So this book, I think for the, you know, half of the book was very emotional. So I cried a lot. What made me cry so much was death of all the best people in this book. For example, death of Karna, Eglaiva, Duryodhana, Bhishma. So these were literally very emotional. I liked this book so much. And what was so very emotional than all the other things was how Ashwatthama perceive everything. So the last part, the book ends with Ashwatthama telling about his friends, and it was literally very emotional and I cried very badly. The next and the final book on the list would be a non-fiction. It is called When Breath Becomes Air by Dr. Paul Kalanithi. So it is a memoir written by Dr. Paul Kalanithi, who was an American neurosurgeon. So it is his journey about how he faced his cancer and that journey. So it was one of the best books I have read, but it was very emotional because all the books that I told you about were, you know, fictional, so we could handle that because at the end of the day it was fictional. But the thing with this book is it's very much true, and Dr. Paul Kalanithi is not with us anymore, and yeah, it was very, very emotional. And the book stopped abruptly because before completing the book itself, the author died, and it has been finished by his wife, so she would have written an epilogue about what happened after his death. So that was the most, you know, emotional part for me. I literally cried so much, and yeah, this book was very different from all the others because it was true, and it took me a lot of time to get over from this book. What I really liked about this book was the way he had written very strongly and bravely, and that is the best thing about this book. These are the top 5 books that made me cry so very much, and these are the best books. I love these books so very much, and I would highly recommend for you guys to read. So that's all for today's video. So I'll be making another video and meeting you guys in real soon. So thank you, bye bye. So like, share and subscribe to Naughty Book Arazi. Have a great day, bye bye, take care.